Disappointing first 45 minutes.
No, I think I'd take full responsibility first half. We'd worked all week on you know trying to actually counter attack down the sides of Swansea and get passes off and then get runners in and bring them onto us and you know just play through. We've done very well at certain clubs doing that. And I came in at half time and said to the lads, you know, they were really down in the dumps at half time. That's my fault, my responsibility. Second half, we played a little bit more on the front foot. We turned their midfield players around and made them defend a bit more. And I think the longer the game went on second half, the more dominant we became.
Did you think you should have had a second penalty in there?
No, I've actually spoken to Jerome. I think Jerome's JT has he's actually fallen over without any touch. He'll get fined for that. And I think Shamak did it as well first half, and he'll get fined as well. I think that over the past couple of years, the country has cleared those situations up much better. And he's been in and seen the referee and apologised to the referee, which is good. But I just don't have it at football clubs I manage.
What did you make of the penalty incident?
Well, I think the first touch is outside, but I think if you have a look, and again, it's only from Crystal Palace point of view, I think he does touch him a second time in the box. Well, the rules are the rules, and you have to. Mike will have to. You know, he sticks with the rules, doesn't he?
So, given the success you had in the second half to your front, do you regret not starting in the second half?
No, I. We've played with Shamak, we've off someone and then breaking forward. Most probably that if I started again, most probably play with one forward and then Shamak in behind. I think it's very difficult playing against teams who play three in midfield, who control the ball like Swansea do. I think if you have a look at, and Swansea are one of the best passing teams in English football. If you have a look at the good passing teams, they'll murder you if you don't match them up in midfield. And, you know, like I say, even second half, Cameron Jerome was dropping in, I don't know if you noticed, but actually dropped in onto Britain and evened the numbers up when we didn't have the ball and broke from there. But what we did, we started with three midfield players that we were hoping would come off the sides and support Shamak, which didn't happen. And like I say, that's my fault.
Glenn Murray obviously won the penalty, took it superbly.
I said to Keith, I walked over to Keith because I hadn't seen him take a penalty. You know, what was he like? He said, well, wait and see. So he edged his bets a little bit just in case.
Think Swansea faded, Tony? You know all about playing after a European game.
Well, I haven't spoke to Gary yet, but it'll be interesting to see what he says. But I think a lot of teams come back from Europe and play at home and do quite well. I don't think that's the problem. I think when teams come back and then have to travel again, like we did six times at Stoke, out of seven games in Europe, out of 6 of ours was away. And it was only after the Valencia game that we played Norwich at home and we actually beat Norwich. So it's the home game is not too bad. I think that the difficult game is actually coming in from Europe and then having to travel again. That is really difficult.
Punch, he's
looked tired the last couple of weeks, and with the wide players we've got with Balassi, Thomas, and players like that, then you know you've got the opportunity to sometimes give them a rest.
Murray come back after injury, you know, it's good for him.
It's great for us as well because, you know, he's goal scorers are streaky and he's got his first goal now. So you're hoping he gets 4 or 5 goals from now until the end of the season because we'll need him. You know, it's a great result. We're delighted to pick a point up at Swansea. Swansea are an established Premier League club now and a very good Premier League club. They won't have no trouble staying in this league, as far as I'm concerned. To come here and get a point is really, really good. And, you know, like I say, we've got to be maximum. We've got to be full maximum every week to pick results up to keep us in the Premiership. Because we've got a real tough, tough task ahead.
Could you just talk a bit about how hard Murray will have worked to have got himself fit to the Wednesday?
Well, Glenn has spent, you know, getting in at 9 o'clock and finishing 4 or 5 o'clock in the afternoon for 6 or 7 months. And you know, the kid has been desperate to play in the Premiership. To get the injury and then for the club to get promoted and him to be left out of all the, you know, the rigmarole that goes with playing in the Premiership. Obviously it was a big, big disappointment for him, but he's worked tirelessly and he deserves it.